Ilias P. Cassidiaris, Greek, Eta Lambda Alpha Pi Kappa Alpha Sigma Iota Delta Iota Rho Eta, born November 29, 1980, is a member of the Greek Parliament and spokesperson of the far-right Golden Dawn Party. Early in personal life, Ilias Cassidiaris was born on November 29, 1980 in Piraeus, Greece. Cassidiaris' father, Panagiotis Cassidiaris, is a retired doctor while his mother is a teacher in philology with a specialization in archaeology. He also has a brother called Alexis. His grandfather is alleged to have been a Nazi collaborationist during the Axis occupation of Greece. As a child, he was attracted to gymnastics, martial arts, writing and history. For many years, he had been taking dance classes, including tango. During his military service, he served in the 1st Raider/Paratrooper Brigade and more specifically in the Gamma Amphibious Raider Squadron in Chios. He holds a degree in agriculture with a speciality in food chemistry from the Agricultural University of Athens. Cassidiaris bears a tattoo on his arm of an ancient Greek meander symbol, widely reported as swastika composed of Grecian key meanders, a logo of his party. Anti-mosque protest. Cassidiaris was present at an anti-mosque protest in Athens on the November 4, 2016. The protest centered around the Syriza government's state-funded mosque build that used Greek Navy land and state financing for its construction. This has received negative publicity both home across the political spectrum, and was reported abroad, as the government were cutting back public spending on Greek citizens who are predominantly, over 98%, Greek Orthodox Christians. However, both the government and opposition supported the construction of the first mosque in Athens despite general negativity within the parties due to the financial and constitutional implications. Further friction was caused by the Syriza government, who sought to reduce the influence of the Greek Orthodox Church in the Hellenic society. Controversies. Cassidiaris quoted the Protocols of the Elders of Zion in a October 23, 2012 speech to Parliament. Defending himself in a discussion of whether to lift his parliamentary immunity over his assault of Canali, he quoted the passage, "In order to destroy the prestige of heroism, we shall send them for trial in the category of theft, murder, and every kind of abominable and filthy crime." Cassidiaris, as well as two of his Golden Dawn colleagues, had their immunities stripped by a unanimous vote of the Parliament. In mid-2013, while in the Parliament, Cassidiaris implied that he and other members of Parliament were Holocaust deniers. Omicron. On September 17, 2013, Cassidiaris and a number of other Golden Dawn lawmakers were arrested on September 28, 2013 on charges of belonging to a criminal organization and are due to appear in court. The charge sheet includes murder, extortion, and involvement in the disappearance of up to 100 migrants. On October 2, 2013, Ilias Cassidiaris was released on a €50,000 bail. On April 2, 2014, Takis Baltikos and Ilias Cassidiaris were recorded on video discussing the incarceration of Golden Dawn lawmakers. Takis Baltikos, Samaras's most trusted advisor and chief of staff, was filmed accusing Samaras of instigating a judicial inquiry against the Golden Dawn Party for political gain. That week, Parliament voted to lift the immunity from prosecution of five Golden Dawn deputies. Justice Minister Athanasiou and Citizen Protection Minister Dendias were implicated in the video. Baltikos was forced to resign but then revealed that New Democracy and Golden Dawn has an informal alliance, with parliamentary voting support. The pre-trial detention and house arrest ahead of a trial was the most significant mass roundup of lawmakers since the military coup in 1967. On July 10, 2014, Cassidiaris was taken into custody in Korydallos prison, on a charge of weapons possession with the intent to supply a criminal organization. On July 1, 2015, Cassidiaris was released from custody after the Council of Appeals Court judges deemed that the legal weight of the offense was not adequate to justify detention. Cassidiaris must report regularly to his local police station and under the conditions of his release is not allowed to visit Golden Dawn's political offices. On July 15, 2015, during rancorous debates in the Greek Parliament on the passing of various bills required as a precursor to the commencement on negotiations to receive a third bailout of the Greek economy, footage of Cassidiaris tearing up papers during an impassioned speech made news reports around the world. Televised Dura Kanali assault. On June 7, 2012, during a television appearance on ANT1, Cassidiaris, in response to a verbal disagreement, threw a glass of water at Greek politician Rina Dura, and then proceeded to physically assault Liana Kanali after she struck him with a piece of paper. The heated exchange was a fluid discussion focusing on the rights of immigrant works vs. right of the unemployed Greek and the development of gas reservoirs in northern Crete, eventually disintegrating from a heated debate to broken rhetoric from both sides about opinion on the regime of the colonels to the persecution of Golden Dawn activists. The discussion broke down when Kanali referred to Cassidiaris as a fascist Phi Alpha Sigma Sigma Tau Alpha. Cassidiaris responded by derogatorily calling her an old communist Pi Alpha Lambda Iota Kappa Omicron Mu Mu Omicron Nu Iota. Dura intervened and said there was a democratic crisis in Greece and that Golden Dawn would take the country back 500 years. Cassidiaris threw the water at Dura, and Dura grinned at the subsequent scuffle as Kanali hit Cassidiaris with a paper and Cassidiaris pushed her back and slapped her multiple times. In Greece it was openly debated by the press whether Cassidiaris had been right or wrong and he was widely cheered online. In March 2015 Cassidiaris attended court to face charges of grievous bodily harm. Giorgos Papadakis, a presenter and journalist who witnessed the assault, stated that threats were also made to television crew and other employees. Political analyst Theodore Kolourambis told Reuters that the sight of a young man slapping up a woman could cost the far-right party votes, especially with women, though other experts thought images of violence could play in their favor. A Facebook page dedicated to Cassidiaris picked up 6,000 likes within 24 hours. Cassidiaris was also awaiting trial for allegedly being the getaway driver for an armed assault on a university professor in Athens in 2007. He was found innocent of all charges relating to the 2007 incident in March 2013, due to a lack of evidence against him.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.